See, this is lecture number 4 from the topic transportation. We are going to study about heart. What is heart? Heart is hollow, muscular and pumping organ. Hollow internally, that is a cavity is present inside, which is filled with blood, made up of muscles, hence muscular, and it pumps the blood so that blood will be distributed to all parts of the body, hence pumping organ. Where heart is situated? This heart is mediastinum. Its position is mediastinum. Mediastinum means present between two lungs. After that, we have to study about weight of the heart. What's the weight of heart? This weight of the heart is 300 grams in case of males and 250 grams in case of females. Later on we have to see about the shape. What is the shape of heart? This shape of heart is conical. How we can say this conical? See, the heart is like this fist-like structure. This fist-like structure, which is broader at the upper end and it is conical at the lower end. It is, we can say, narrow at the lower end. Same is about the heart, broad at the upper end and conical towards the lower end. Or we can say it is narrow towards the lower end. So, shape of the heart is conical. After that, we have to study about its external structure. What it includes, what is come under external structure. Under external structure, we have to study about its coverings, pericardium and its... See, under external structure, what we have to study. Externally, heart is covered by some membranes. The membranes which covers the heart are pericardium. This pericardium, it have two membranes. These two membranes of pericardium are, first one is the visceral pericardium. This visceral pericardium is found attached to the wall of heart. And second covering is called as parietal. This parietal pericardium is found above the visceral pericardium. That means what? If we consider this is the heart, then this heart is covered by a membrane. Exact membrane which covers the heart will become visceral pericardium. Above that there will be gap and one more covering is there, that will become parietal pericardium. Remember that in between visceral pericardium and parietal pericardium, a cavity is present which is called as pericardial cavity, and this pericardial cavity is filled with a fluid. This cavity filled with a fluid which is called as pericardial fluid. What is the function of this pericardial fluid? As this fluid is present in between two membranes, between visceral and parietal pericardium, that means if the gap it is present, so it acts as shock absorber. Shock absorber means what? It prevents the shock waves reaching towards the heart. So, first function is to protect the heart from shock waves. And second function is it acts as lubricant, that means provide free movement to the heart. So performing two important functions, protecting the heart and providing free movement. Okay, so this is about the membranes which surrounds the heart. We have to study now about the wall of heart. Actual wall of the heart, that means inside the pericardium. What I said, this is a fist shaped heart. Covering, one internal covering is the visceral pericardium, then gap, and then one more covering, that is parietal pericardium. So this is the actual heart. This my hand means the actual heart. So this wall is made up of which material? So if we consider this is a hollow muscular organ, inside here there will be the hollow cavity, and this wall is made up of which layers? This wall of the heart is of three layers. Which are the three layers of heart? These three layers of the heart are, first one is called as epicardium. As the name suggests, epicardium is the outermost covering. Middle layer is called as myocardium. And the inner layer is called as endocardium. See, all these words ends with the word cardium. Cardium means what? Cardium is always
heart.
And this layers AP, myo, endo. AP outermost, endo innermost, and word myo means the muscles. That means it is the middle layer which is made up of cardiac muscles. So remember that epicardium and endocardium are made up of squamous epithelial cells, or we can say flat epithelial cells. And this myocardium is the actual layer of the muscles, of the cardiac muscles, which bring about pumping action of the heart. Now once again, inside the external structure, in the heading, external structure, what can we see? Externally, this heart, it shows four chambers, as already you know, I think. In case of mammals, heart is a four-chambered structure. So this heart, it becomes a four-chambered structure. In this four-chamber structure, these upper two chambers are called as atria. Remember that. Upper two chambers are called as atrium. Atria is the plural one, atrium is the singular one. And these two lower chambers are called as ventricles. So this four-chambered structure is seen from the external structure. You can see that these two atria are separated from the ventricles. Here a groove is seen, this depression is seen which separates the atrium from the ventricle. From both the sides this groove is seen. This groove is called as coronary sulcus. Remember that. It becomes coronary sulcus. Word sulcus means depression. Now we are going to see about the ventricles. Here these ventricles are present, and this is the separated, this line, it shows the separation between these two ventricles. But from the external surface, we can see here two interventricular sulcus are present, two interventricular depressions are there like this. Okay, so these two depressions present on the wall of this ventricle is called as interventricular sulci. These interventricular sulci are there. What's the function of interventricular sulci? For what purpose the depressions are there? On this wall in the diagram, you can see in the diagram given in the textbook, you can see that your coronary artery and coronary veins are present in these depressions. So this interventricular sulci are the depressions present over, for what purpose? For presence of coronary artery. What's the meaning of this word coronary artery and coronary vein? This coronary artery supplies pure blood to the wall of heart, and coronary vein, it collects impure blood from the wall of heart. That means from functioning of heart, for the proper functioning of heart, blood is supplied by coronary artery, supplying oxygenated blood. This oxygenated blood, once used by the heart, well, heart muscles, becomes deoxygenated. And this deoxygenated blood is collected by coronary vein, and this coronary vein, it opens into this right atrium. Okay. Now we are going to see about the blood vessels which opens into different parts of the heart. This right side of the heart, it is concerned with deoxygenated blood. It receives deoxygenated blood with this superior vena cava. This blood vessel is called as superior vena cava, collecting deoxygenated blood from upper part of the body. Second blood vessel, here this one, it is called as inferior vena cava. This inferior vena cava, it collects deoxygenated blood from lower part of the body. Then from this right ventricle, externally only the blood vessels which comes out from the different part of the heart can be seen. This right ventricle, from the right ventricle, this blood vessel arises. It is called as pulmonary artery. So this is the pulmonary artery which comes out from the right ventricle, is visible. From the left side of the heart, here you can see another blood vessel which comes out. This blood vessel, which is a major blood vessel, comes out from the left side of the ventricle. It is called as aorta. Remember that this biggest blood vessel, it is called as aorta. And this blood vessel which comes out from right ventricle, it is called as pulmonary artery. Okay, so pulmonary artery it carries deoxygenated blood and it goes to the lung. In the lung, purification of blood takes place, and this purified blood, it opens into, that means it is get collected into the left atrium through these four pulmonary veins. So this is about the structure which is seen externally. Now we have to study about aorta. What is visible in case of aorta? This aorta is divided into three parts. Which are these three parts of the aorta? The aorta which ascends upward, that means which runs upward, will become ascending aorta. This main branch which turns downward, actually in this way, this aorta, it turns downward like this. So this is called as systemic aorta. This much part will become systemic aorta or aortic arch. And the aorta which goes downward will become descending aorta. So ascending aorta, systemic arch, and this becomes a descending aorta. This actual branch, or we can say systemic aorta, it consists of three branches. Which are these three branches coming out from the region of the systemic aorta? These branches are, these three branches, this branch is called as subclavian, this is called as common carotid, and this is called as brachiocephalic. So these three branches comes out, this one subclavian, this is common carotid, and this one is called as brachiocephalic. According to their name, this applies to the different part. Subclavian goes to head region, right side of the head region. Common carotid, it also applies to the brain region, and brachiocephalus goes to the shoulder, and we can say the part related with shoulder and all. Later on, the last part of this heart we have to study is about the pulmonary artery, which divides into two branches and goes to the lungs for purification. So in 1 minute I am going to summarize it. What is this external structure? What we have studied? Its exact position, the presence of heart wall, the membranes which covers the heart, that means pericardium, and externally what is visible. Only one thing you have to remember, that is this pulmonary artery and aorta, they are joined together, which is shown by ductus arteriosus, ligamentum arteriosum, which is the remnant of ductus arteriosus. Okay, later on we are going to study about internal structure of heart.